जरूरी है सो दैट यू कैन मैक्सिमाइज एंड यू कैन स्ट्रीमलाइन योर एनर्जी एंड गिव इट 100% टू द ओपोनेंट. ठीक है, सो वी विल स्टडी लाइक अ फ्यू प्रिंसिपल्स बिहाइंड अ पंच. नथिंग रॉकेट साइंस, ये सब आपको ऑलरेडी पता है. बट आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू टेक अ फ्यू मिनट्स ऑफ योर्स एंड वी गो ओवर इट अगेन. ठीक है, सो आई ड्रू दिस little line diagram here just to give you an idea of what's happening inside your body with the energy when you're throwing a punch. So we'll start with this part. So it's basically a person. I don't know if you can figure out, it's actually a person throwing a punch. So this support of the ankle with the ground, how the force is passing in one line, it's not going like this, you know, like this. It's passing in one line. Straight to the opponent. So if you were, so everyone knows about the laws of physics. There's a third law of Newton. If you apply, say, 1,000 newtons of force to the ground will give you back 1,000 newtons. Okay? So and that's also the law of energy. So there is no energy being lost. If I put 1,000, 1,000 comes back. No energy is lost. But what is happening is the energy is getting transformed. Okay? I know I'm throwing a lot of terms, but I'm trying to give you a gist of what you're going to be talking in this session. So for example, you use one type of energy here and you change it to another kind of energy when you throw a punch. But it's the same 1,000 newtons that you generated when you used the ground and you put all that energy on your opponent without losing any with your wiggly movements in the way. Okay? So we'll cover a few things today. We'll start with the ankle. Ankle ka kya role hai? Uske baad hum knee ki baat karenge. Because everything starts from the ground up. This is the foundation. Okay, so we'll go like that till your fist and how it reaches the opponent. We'll start with ankle. Second hoga knee. Third hoga aapka hip kaisa hai. Okay, four will be your core, which is very important. Fifth will be I'll say your shoulder. Plus your upper back. Because it's all of this and your shoulder. It's not the shoulder starting from this joint alone. No. It's this and your shoulder. Then we'll talk about your elbow. So from the shoulder we come to the elbow. Then we come up on your forearm. Which is another important factor. And last, we come to your wrist or your fist. Then we talk about what are we using in the hand. And then our target is the opponent. So all this, starting from the ground, how we use those 1,000 newtons of energy, conserve it through the way and give it back to the opponent. Okay? Now if we are not throwing a punch in a good way, we can lose so many of it on the way. And maybe it appears like you're throwing a good punch, but maybe it's only 300 that you're giving back to the opponent. You're thinking, oh, I'm using the ground, but he doesn't seem to react. रिएक्ट, इट लुक्स लाइक उसको कुछ हो ही नहीं रहा है और मैं अपनी एनर्जी यूज कर रहा हूँ और मैं इतना टायर्ड फील कर रहा हूँ पर वो टायर्ड नहीं हो रहा है. सो वॉट एम आई डूइंग रॉन्ग, वाई एम आई सो टायर्ड? सो अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज टुडे इज ऑल अबाउट हाउ वी कैन यूज our energy, because we do not have to lose our energy. We have to be so smart. We have to conserve it, give it to the muscles that need it. Agar kisi muscle ko contract nahi karna to usko contract mat karo, because har ek contraction mein tum apni energy waste kar rahe ho. To suppose agar tum punch karte hue isko bilkul aise tight kar rahe ho, it doesn't have to be tight. Make it loose, okay? You don't have to isometrically contract everything. Some parts have to be tight because they are your foundation, but some parts have to be relaxed. They have to be just flex or extend. Zaruri nahi hai ki aapne flexion ke saath isometric bhi karna hai. No, aap sirf flex karo. Make sense?
Okay.
So going to talk about each of these parts now. ठीक है, अभी तक सबको समझ आ रहा है? So, say we start from the ground up. So, ankle का क्या role है? Ankle का बहुत important role है in your stability, in your foundation. अगर मेरा ankle floor पर, ground पर अच्छे से नहीं है, if I'm twisting my ankle, or if I'm not using the entire surface of my ankle, what is happening is there is a thing called ground reaction force. That means agar maine itte se area se apna force lagaya, so maybe this will be only 500 because I'm not using a lot of area also. So the amount of force I get is 500. But if I increase my area, if I use my full contact, I'm going to get more back. I give more, I get more. If I give only this much, I don't get enough. You can injure yourself, you can lose your balance. No, I want a strong foundation. My ankle is going to be on the ground. Be it this ankle, be it that ankle. It's going to be on the ground. That is very important. What I heard from Coach Ron is, you're going like this. I don't know if I'm doing it right, but the contact is not there. That needs to happen. If you're only applying force from here, guess what? The amount of force coming back from the ground is also going to be this much. If you're using your full contact and your full pressure, imagine you get back this. And the same, if you use it nicely, it goes back to the opponent. If you generate this, you're going to lose some on the way and you're only throwing back this much. Okay, so this is the most important, a good foundation. So you push down from the ankle, the ground gives you back some energy. All right, I've got some energy stored inside me. Okay? This energy in physics, which you have stored inside your body, is called a potential energy. And what we are doing during a punch, using physics, we are converting that potential energy into a kinetic energy and blowing a punch. And then the opponent can feel it. So we are not losing the energy, we are conserving the energy, but transforming it from one part to another. So suppose I got this 1,000 units of energy. Now my goal is, how do I use the 1,000 energy that I got here completely here? I don't have to lose it on my way. I have to be very smart. So what do I do with my ankle? Okay, I've got 1,000 energy here. My knee is my next important step. I don't wobble my knee. I keep my knee solid, so I can transfer the energy. Okay? I have my energy here now. So my knee was not like this, because then I lost it. I'm flexing extra muscles, the energy is lost. I have a stable energy and now I've got it here. Okay, so the 1,000 units of energy is now sitting on my pelvic area. Okay, say 500 here, 500 here. And I have to throw, gosh, I'm bad at this. If I have to throw a punch like that, a jab like that, what I have to do is, I have to now transfer that. So I have to then transfer it. So I have 1,000 here, but I have to be able to transfer the force from one hip to the other hip, and then to the opponent. So the transfer here is very important, because you don't want to lose it, okay? Say you have 500 plus 500. You should be able to transfer the force. That's why the mobility here is very important, because this is where you're going to get the force here, and this is what you're using. If you lose it on the way here, because very well you can, then what you're throwing is not efficient. Okay, so by far I've been able to get all my 1,000 units here. Okay, I started here, I've been able to get it here. Now how do I transfer it to the opponent? Okay, the next big group that's going to conserve my energy and carry it up is going to be my core area. Okay, because if I'm bending, if my core is weak, I'm going to give so much energy to the other muscles that I will lose 200 maybe on the way, and what I bring up is only 800. No, that's not efficient. My mom gave me 1,000 rupees. I have to give it back to her. I can't lose it on the way. My mom will beat me. Okay, and that was your opponent. Okay? So we have to think about every, I don't have to give it to the muscles. I don't have to give the energy to the muscles that do not need to contract. I have to be very smart about it. Okay. So I have it here. So say for example, 500, 500. I'm able to bring it to the hip. That is going to help me in the jab. I'm able to transfer it and send it to my core. My core is tight and strong. Just 1 second. Let me make sure I'm going what I have to do. Yes, so the core is tight and I should be able to shift it from one hip to the other. Alright, so I've got it to till the core here. Okay, core was tight. If I did not have a strong core and I was flexing it or I was extending it like that, no, I lost some energy. Because what happens when you're using any muscle, when you're tensing any muscle, you have to give something to the body. Okay, it's a give and take relationship. So if you flex too much, you give too much energy. If you are smart, you save your energy. So next part is the most important, because this is where the chain will start of when I'm throwing a punch. The punch is not coming just from my shoulder socket and here, and it's not coming just from my leg. Coming from here all the way to the opponent. Okay, so this, if I've been able to conserve my energy till the core and keep my 1,000 rupees, excellent. Okay, because this part all the boxers should master. So once you've got it here, now you'll master. Okay, so what you do is you use these muscles all the way to your shoulder, and it's all connected. It's not just this joint, okay? This joint is this is your shoulder joint. Not very good at drawing. This is your ball. It's a ball and socket. So it's a socket. My body is a socket. and this is my shoulder. Most of the time we think that the energy is just being produced here in the socket and the ball, but no. What is actually happening is it's coming from the ground up using these muscles to the shoulder and out. Okay, we'll talk about that a little bit in detail later, but I want to emphasize that this is what you're using in a punch. Okay, so say for example, by now I've been able to bring my 1,000 units of energy and now I have it sitting here. Okay, what I need to do now is transfer. So what I do next, I start with conserving the energy in my shoulder. Now what Coach Ron told me was one thing that most of the boxers do is they will be like this. So what I'm using is I'm using extra muscles of my shoulder. But what I could do instead is conserve my energy, bring the elbows in, bring the shoulders in. Bring the shoulders in and conserve. Okay, the moment I have it out, guess what? My shoulders are unnecessarily getting tired. So bring the shoulders in. Just one second, I need water. We are at the shoulder, the most important joint, the most commonly injured joint. Okay, so how do we act smartly in not losing any energy in the shoulder? Most important, because I want to keep my 1,000. And second most important, how do I make sure I'm not putting my shoulder in a compromised position जहाँ पर उसको इंजरी हो सकती है? ठीक है, तो मुझे क्या करना है? मुझे अपना शोल्डर अपने पास रखना है, उसको जाने नहीं देना. सो कीप योर एल्बो इन, बिकॉज जब आप एबडक्शन, इस मूवमेंट को बोलते हैं एबडक्शन, जब आप एबडक्शन करते हो तो बहुत सारी मसल्स यूज हो रही है फालतू में. ठीक है, आपका यहाँ डेल्टॉइड, आपकी यहाँ वाली मसल्स सब फालतू में यूज हो रही हैं जो आपको नहीं करनी थी. जस्ट कीप इट इन. If you have to throw a jab, it goes from here. If you have to throw a hook, maybe thoda sa bahar and then here. It doesn't have to be like travel. No. You lost so much energy. It could have just gone from here. I'm not doing it very well, but you get my point. It doesn't have to waste the energy, because but then what you did, you lost 200 on the way. And what you probably have is only 800. No. That's not the point we are discussing. We want to conserve our 1,000. Okay? So how do I do it? I keep it close. So now I have the energy sitting on my shoulder. And now I have the responsibility of saving it. So the first thing is I keep it close to me. So I keep my elbow in. Okay? If I keep it out, I'm losing energy. And the second thing, I'm getting injured. My chances of injury are increasing. Because what happens is, when your shoulder is close to you, this is a closed socket. So my ball is nicely packed inside the socket. When I bring my elbow out, so what is happening inside? So imagine, this is my body and this is my humerus, this bone. जब आपका एल्बो बिल्कुल पास में है तो ये अच्छे से अंदर बैठा हुआ है. द मोमेंट आप अपना एल्बो बाहर लेके आए, क्या हो रहा है? ये अब ऐसे हो गया, एक्सपोज हो गया. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा ये वाला हिस्सा बाहर आ गया. पहले तो अच्छे से अंदर था, जब आप अपना एल्बो बाहर लेके आए तो अब शोल्डर एक्सपोज हो गया. और जो शोल्डर को प्रोटेक्ट करता है, एक बोलते हैं लेब्रम, LABRUM. लेब्रम इंजरी इज वेरी कॉमन इन बॉक्सर्स. जब आप बाहर लेकर आते हो तो जो बाहर की प्रोटेक्शन होती है वो स्ट्रेच हो जाती है, कॉम्प्रोमाइज हो जाती है. एंड देन अगर आपको कोई अच्छे से पंच लगा और आपने कंट्रोल नहीं करा वो फोर्स, सो यू प्रीडिस्पोज योरसेल्फ टू शोल्डर इंजरीज. शोल्डर इंजरीज के चांसेस बढ़ जाते हैं. तो आपने अपने शोल्डर को वो कॉम्प्रोमाइज पोजिशन में नहीं लाना है. आपने वो लेब्रम और जो हेड है वो टाइट रखना है. ठीक है, जब आप बाहर लेकर आओगे तो वो वीक पोजिशन में आ गया. सो टू थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग, एनर्जी इज गेटिंग लॉस्ट एंड इंजरी चांसेस आर इंक्रीजिंग. सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू कीप इट विद योरसेल्फ. यू लूज द एनर्जी. फालतू में क्यों बाहर रखना है? पता नहीं, गेट टायर्ड. ठीक है, बिकॉज मसल्स को ऐसे होल्ड करने में भी कितना एनर्जी लग रहा है. So just keep it with you, keep it conserved. Okay. So I was very smart. I used the energy. I kept the elbow with me. I kept my shoulder tucked in. And I was able to bring 1,000 units here. I've done a great job so far. I've been able to stabilize my ankle, stabilize my knee, transfer the force to my hip, keep my core tight. Use my lats, my muscles here, keep my shoulder in, bring the energy here. Okay? 1,000 all the way. Now, small task left. But if I mess up here, nothing is happening to the opponent. This was all a waste. Okay? So I'm thinking now, okay, what do I do now? This is your driver. Okay? You got all the passengers, all the 1,000 passengers here. But if the driver messes up, okay, the driver is not concentrating, the driver is on the phone, guess what? There might be an accident. 500 of your passengers get injured. And what you're only giving back to the destination is 500. No, that's not a good job. This part has a huge responsibility, because now this is the part, the only part that's going to transfer the force to the opponent. So I conserve the energy here and I don't have to make it stiff, because then I'm losing some. No, I have to conserve, I have to keep my 1,000. So I keep this part relaxed, but I keep this part stiff, because guess what? If this is not stiff, then I'm losing some again. Okay? And I have to keep it stiff. So that I can, use my 1,000 and throw it to the opponent. So another important thing to note here. Okay, so far we are talking about the wrist. I've been able to, so if you notice on the way, there were some parts that were using as a stabilizer. There were some parts that were relaxed, like for example, this part. Okay, there were some parts that were tight, some parts that were relaxed. Okay, so by far I've been able to bring my 1,000 units here. Now, for example, there could be two cases. There could be a case where you're not actively maybe punching. That moment, maybe you keep your wrist a little bit relaxed, but the moment you're throwing the punch, the area has to reduce. Okay? Because what happens? I'm just going to throw in a little bit of physics here. This is what? This is pressure. This is force. This is area. Okay? Now, if my area is too much, so if I have to throw water on you all and I bring a hose, okay? And the hose is this wide. What's happening? The pressure is so low because the area is so big. So you're not feeling it. But if I have to make sure that I'm hitting it on Vishal and he feels the pressure of the water, what I do? I put my finger, I make the area smaller of the hose, so I completely target it on him. Right? Aise karte hai na, pipe pe agar pani focus karna hota hai to. Agar itna bada pipe hai to speed nahi aayega, pressure nahi aayega. Pressure lana hai to area kam karna padega. So if I'm throwing a punch like this, no pressure, because the area is so much. If I reduce the area, guess what? Area kam hoga, pressure zyada hoga. Area zyada hoga, प्रेशर कम होगा. सो माय एरिया हैज टू बी रिड्यूस्ड. आई एम नॉट थ्रोइंग अ पंच लाइक दैट यूजिंग ऑल दिस एरिया. आई एम यूजिंग मिनिमम एरिया. ओके, टॉकिंग अबाउट एरिया, आई हैव बीन एबल टू ब्रिंग दिस टू माय हैंड. नाउ व्हाट एम आई यूजिंग इन माय हैंड? आई हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट आई एम कीपिंग दिस प्रिंसिपल. आई हैव टू यूज मिनिमम एरिया टू मैक्सिमाइज द प्रेशर. 1000 यूनिट्स ऑफ एनर्जी है मेरे पास. अब मैं 1000 यूनिट्स ओपोनेंट को कैसे दूं? सम ऑफ अस थिंक कि पंच यहां से जाएगा. नहीं, यहां से नहीं जाएगा. सम ऑफ अस थिंक पंच यहां से जाएगा, यहां से भी नहीं जाएगा. व्हाट कोच रॉन इज टेलिंग अस इज दीज टू नकल्स, दीज टू, द इंडेक्स फिंगर एंड द रिंग फिंगर. दिस इज द एरिया which has saved all your 1000 units of energy and you're throwing the punch. Okay, again, making sure the area is optimal. Okay, we are not using so much extra area. Okay, we're using this area and throwing the punch. Okay, so the whole idea of conserving the energy, using it at the right places, transferring it the same way and sending it. So pretty much what we discussed here. I use my ankle, I push it down with the ground gives me some energy. I transfer it to my hip, use my core, use my lats, ye wala muscle, bring it to my shoulder, elbow, wrist, knuckles and opponent. Okay, I let me just check if I missed anything on the way. Okay, a few other things that I need to stress upon is first thing is, I think from what Coach Ron told me, when some of us throw a jab, what we are doing is, so say for example, I gave you my 1000 rupees because you needed to borrow it, but I need to bring them back. Okay, so I have my 1000 units of energy that I created, I throw it, but I need to bring it back as well. Okay, so if you throw a jab, in boxing terms, if you throw a jab, you bring back your shoulder. You don't just leave it or it's just going somewhere else and now it's sitting on your hip. No. When you throw a jab, the arm needs to come back. So every time there is a reaction, every time there is an action, the reaction should be same of coming back. You need to complete the movement. This is half, and when you come back, this is one. So complete it. Okay? Don't just leave it there and then, okay, I don't know, I'm probably going somewhere else. No. Because if you're losing it, if you're not bringing it back, guess what? The second punch that you're throwing from here is, there is hardly any energy. Because when you're bringing it back, you again use your principle, you gain 1000 and then you gain. Punch again. Start from there, there's nothing left. You don't have any store in the engine. You have to bring it back, use the energy, then throw it. If you start from, so say for example, I threw a jab, I didn't bring my shoulder back and I started from there. Something. It's meaningless. You're getting into a negative tank. You need to bring it back, get those 1000 again and then throw a punch again. Always bring it back, bring it back, bring it back. I need my 1000 back. Okay? So that's the first one. The second one is, we're going to talk a little bit about vectors. I think this is also what Coach Ron has told you multiple times. But when you're throwing a punch, this is the midline. Okay? This. You do not have to cross a midline. So say, imagine this, okay? There is something like that. When I'm throwing a punch, it should not be like that, because then what I did, I crossed it. Or it should not be like that, because then what I did, I crossed it. I wasted my energy. And all this time, what we've been talking about is conserving the energy, being smart, making sure we're going in the right direction without losing any energy, and giving our 1,000. But if you're doing that, if you're crossing the midline, you're losing energy. Nah. Okay? So say, for example, if Coach Ron tells you, you have to throw a punch without crossing the midline. Okay? You don't do like this. Because you're not listening. Okay? Aapko kya karna hai? You have to be smart. Okay, meko Coach Ron ne bola, I don't have to cross the midline. How can I throw a punch this side when I don't cross a midline? Okay, use my common sense. I use my body. Okay? क्योंकि हमने क्या डिस्कस करा है कि हिप्स मोबाइल होना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. अगर मेरे हिप्स स्टिफ है और अगर मैं मूव नहीं कर रही हूँ तो आई एम नॉट यूजिंग माई बॉडी इन द राइट वे एज अ बॉक्सर. ओके, सो कोच रॉन टोल्ड मी मेरे को लेफ्ट साइड पे पंच करना है पर मुझे ये क्रॉस नहीं करना. इट साउंड्स लाइक इम्पॉसिबल बट इट्स नॉट. यू हैव टू यूज योर कॉमन सेंस. वॉट यू हैव टू डू देन, यू हैव टू ट्विस्ट योर बॉडी, यू हैव टू रोटेट एंड देन यू थ्रो अ पंच. Because अभी भी मेरा वेक्टर कहाँ है? I didn't cross it, but I threw a punch here. Are you understanding? मेरे को कोच रॉन ने बोला मेरे को इस पेन को शूट करना है पर मुझे ये क्रॉस नहीं करना है. And you're thinking, how is that possible? But it is possible. Because right now what you're thinking is, I'm going to keep standing straight. No. You have to use your body. So what you do is, you go like that. You never crossed it. Coach, my pen was on the left. And I just turned my body and it's on my right now. So you understand this? So similarly, coach ne bola ki cross nahi karna hai. But the pen is on the right. Oh my God, how do I do it? From my left arm, how do I throw a punch on the right? That doesn't make sense. But you can actually do it because when you use your lower body, it's possible. So what you do is like that. Okay? Samajh aaya? Theek hai? Did I miss anything? So, when he says, do not cross the nose, that simply means you have to be smart, you have to use the rest of your body. Because it's not just shoulder in your boxing, it's not just legs, it's the whole body. Okay? And each and every part is very important. Agar aapka ankle theek nahi hai, guess what? So, say for example, ankle was okay, you gained 1,000, your knee was a little bit wobbly, or it was too much flexed unnecessarily, you lost 100 here. Okay, now I have 900. I did not transfer my force. I'm only left with 500. So if I keep losing energy on the way, then what am I doing? Okay, I'm just getting tired unnecessarily at the end of the practice, but I was not even able to make that impact. I'm getting more tired than my opponent because I'm using extra energy, which I don't have to. Alright, so when you're throwing a jab or a hook, whatever, your shoulder should always come back to the same point. We also, I think, discussed a little bit about when you're throwing a hook, and I talked about shoulder bahar nahi jana chahiye. Jitna zyada aapka shoulder andar rahega, jitna zyada aapka elbow pass mein rahega, utna better. Aapko jab throw karna hai, aapko hook throw karna hai. Hook doesn't mean that it has to travel all the way. No. One thing, lost energy, two things, increase injury. So elbow in. ठीक है? कुछ अगर कोई पार्ट मेरे को फिर से रिपीट करना है तो बता दो. कोई भी. सबको क्लियर है? Okay. What did I say the forearm was? The forearm is the driver. Okay? My driver is wobbly, if my driver is unattentive, mera sara kaam jo maine sare passengers pick up kare the from all the way here, my passengers are going to hate me and they will not cooperate with me and they will go. important part. Is my punch coming from my leg? No. Is my punch coming only from my shoulder? No. My punch is coming from all the force I generated and brought here. And it's a combination of all my muscles of the upper back, from my shoulder up to my knuckles and the opponent. Okay, so it's not a one-man job. It's not a one-man job. It's your whole body going in synchrony, conserving the forces, conserving the energy on the way, and then throwing that 1,000 energy on the opponent. Okay? Yeah? I guess I covered everything here on. Okay, sweet. Okay, any questions? No question is silly question. Mujhe hindi mein pooch sakte ho, koi baat. Puch to? Nahi? Pakka? So now if Coach Ron expects that you understand, you understand. Otherwise, koi purpose nahi tha yahan pe aane ka. Theek hai? So, all these 7 things are helping you in throwing a punch. It's not only coming from your shoulder, it's not only coming from your elbow or anything. It starts from the ground up. If the foundation is poor, okay, if I only use my ankle talk, if I'm a ballet dancer and I punch like that, then guess what? Agar mera area kam hai, to mere ko zyada energy nahi mil rahi hai. Okay? I need to use that ground reaction force. Okay? And the more the area, the better. So I can get more. And then I can use it. And then when I have to throw it, I use all my energy. I don't lose it on the way. Okay? So ankle, knee, hip, core, upper back, shoulder, elbow, forearm, wrist, knuckles. Cool. If you don't have any questions, we'll end the lecture here.
One thing. One question. In order for all of this work, to be successful, we have C-O-R-E.
Yes. And we don't forget the principle, the values of a boxer that's been told by Coach Ron. Okay? And I know what it is. And I know it's a 5 alphabet word.
You're talking about Cody, right?
Yeah.
And I'm going to call, it's got 5 alphabets, and I'm going to call any 5 of you, and you're going to come here and tell me what it is. Okay? I'll make it a little bit easy for you, because I'll tell you what the initials are. Much for Manisha, Sanjeev. Tumhe pata? Okay, but the other boxers, no. Right? Okay. So I'm going to first start with Rubel, and he's going to come and tell us what C is.
C is concentration.
Concentration. Very good. Example to ek concentration ka Hindi mein bhi de sakte. What is concentration? An exact example. Kuch
bhi. Focus on one thing. Every time we focus.
Huh. Concentration का मतलब है focus करना, ठीक है? It could be anything. When you're here, you focus on your training. When you're in class, you focus on what the teacher is saying. When you're in the dining hall, you focus on your food. You know what you're eating in the plate. So everywhere you are, you focus. You should know what's happening, but you should know what's going around in your body, what's happening inside your body. Is this muscle tense or is this muscle relaxed? I should know. Okay, concentrate. Okay, what is O? Malum, you know? Huh? Optimism? Optimism?
Let him come up.
Come. Optimism ka koi example do, Hindi mein bhi de sakte ho. Manipuri mein doge, then she will translate. ऑप्टिमिज्म का मतलब क्या होता है हिंदी में? ऑप्टिमिज्म इज स्टेइंग पॉजिटिव. ओके, अच्छा अगर मैं आपको बोलूं कि आपको पॉजिटिव रहना है तो आप कोई एग्जांपल दे सकते हो?
जैसे आप लोग टूर्नामेंट जाते हैं तब कोई गलत नहीं सोचने का, तब पॉजिटिव रहेगा तो सब कुछ अच्छा होगा.
यस, वेरी गुड एग्जांपल. ओके, इट्स नॉट दैट यू आर एट अ टूर्नामेंट एंड यू ऑलरेडी स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ओ हु योर ओपोनेंट इज गोइंग टू बी. यू स्टे ऑप्टिमिस्टिक, आई एम गोइंग टू विन दिस, I have practiced hard and I know what I'm going to do and I'm going to win this. You stay positive, you stay optimistic. Okay, thank you, Malik. Okay, R. You want to tell me, Shubham? Come.
R is for relaxation.
Relaxation. Example doge?
We should always relax our body and relax mind. Same as optimism.
Yeah.
Always relax, don't stress. If you stress, then you're not able to play.
Yeah, and you're not able to also focus. If you're too stressed, you're not able to focus. So it's connected to everything we are doing. Okay. Okay, for E, I want a volunteer. Who will tell me E? Vaishak, you want to? Oh, Uday?
Is for enjoyment.
Enjoyment, so important. हाँ, कोई example दे दो.
We should enjoy what we are doing. We should not take stress.
Exactly. Okay. We are all here. We should enjoy the process. Okay. Not everyone gets the privilege to be in a facility, train. So enjoy the process. Okay. It's not a, it's not a burden. Enjoy it. Because when you will enjoy it, everything will come naturally. D. Vaishak.
D is for discipline. Discipline is nothing but doing what you're supposed to do when you're supposed to do it. Being punctual, and when the window of opportunity opens, you have to be there and seize the opportunity.
Oh, good one. Okay. So everything that we've learned, okay, we will only be able to apply if we have these values as a boxer. Okay. If you're not disciplined or you're not optimistic, you're not going to be used whatever you learned here. Okay, so you use those, you make it a part of your life, you live it every day, and then you focus on this, because this will come naturally. Okay, if you're dedicated, if you're doing all of this, this will happen.
Okay, everybody. Okay. Thank you for giving me. Thank you for giving us your time and this is your first time doing this class, so you should feel privileged. She gave you another aspect as far as physiology,
physics.
So I know I teach a little bit different. Now some of the things that she, she's not a boxing person, but she's good at physics and energy. So hopefully you guys understood what she gave you, and that you can use it in your boxing. All right. Once again, thanks again, Samir. We appreciate your time. It was great. All right.
Bye-bye.